Hi everyone. Today we're gonna make a really simple thank you card. It's super simple. You don't need too many things. But we're first gonna start off by I sometimes buy pre-made cards. This is a Kraft card, and the card measures 5.5 by 4 inches. And again, it's in Kraft cardstock. I happen to really like Kraft cardstock. I think it's really cute. Really like earthy. I love it. And this is the envelope here. We're not going to use this right away, so I'm just going to place that there. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead. The card is already pre-scored, so I'm just going to go ahead and fold it. And with my bone folder, I'm just going to make sure that that's really nice and folded and crisp. Okay, and because they come pre-folded, the top of your card is not going to crack. Okay, so what I've done is I've pre-cut a piece of designer paper, and this is from Sandylion. I don't remember exactly the name of the paper because I cut it off to fit into my storage box. But it is from Sandylion, I do remember that. And this is cut down to 5 by 3.5 inches. And actually, before we adhere it down, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take my corner rounder and I'm going to round all the edges. Front and back, and top and bottom. Okay. So now this is what your card looks like. Okay, you have your corners rounded. Okay. Next, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to round all these edges as well on your cardstock. And now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to glue the edges here of this paper. And I'm just using my ATG gun. I don't always use it. Sometimes I feel it's too bulky for my projects. But in this case, I'm just using it. It's just the closest thing to me right now. Okay, so that looks good to me, so I'm just going to adhere it down. So what we have right now is this, something that looks like this. Very simple. Okay? So next what we're going to do is I'm going to, I have this stamp here. It says thank you, and this is actually from Studio G. I found this in the $1.50 bin here in Canada. It's $1.50, not a dollar. So found this in the bins at Michael's, and I just really like the script of it. So I am just going to emboss it here in the corner. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my Versamark. Don't mind how dirty looking my pad looks. I got sparkles all over it and didn't know how to remove them, so they're just kind of sitting there, but they don't cause any issues with my Versamark, so it's fine. I'll just, when my Versamark gets dried out, I'll just end up buying a new one. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna stamp the sentiment in the corner here. Okay, that looks really cute. Now I'm gonna take my ultra fine white embossing powder. Okay. And did get the excess off, move that over. Okay, so I'm just gonna take my heat gun and heat this up. Perfect. I'm gonna heat the back of the card as well because it kind of warps when you add heat. So as it's drying, you just wanna kind of straighten it out. So this is what you've got right now. Super cute. Okay, and this is just the start. So right now, what we're gonna do is I just have, let's get this out of the way. I have a Martha Stewart Butterfly Punch, okay, and I just have some random pieces of cardstock here. So if you can tell, this one's just a plain pink that I've already kind of played around with. This is just a plain pink. Then we've got this pearlized blue. Might be kind of hard to tell on camera. And then we've got this kind of pearlized, like, it's kind of like a corally pink color. I think it's really cute. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to stamp, or punch out, sorry, some of this, some of these butterflies. So I've got the pink. Punch out some of the coral, and we'll punch out some of the blue. We'll just put those aside. Okay, so now I've got all these butterflies. Before I do anything with the butterflies, I'm gonna take my white gel pen, and this is a Uniball Signo. I'll have all the descriptions of what I'm using at the end of my video, just so there aren't any problems, because I hate myself when I'm watching a video and I'm like, yeah, I gotta get them, that by the time the end of the video comes around, I don't remember what I was so interested in, and then I end up having to watch the whole video again. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna do some faux stitching around the outside of the card. And I'm just going to follow the curved edge of the card. It's really simple. And I love the way the white pen looks on the kraft cardstock. Okay, so this so far is our card. So I've done the white faux stitching around the outside. Okay. Next, I'm going to take my Mono Tombo Multi. And I'm going to simply glue on these little butterflies, if I can pick them up. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to bend them a little bit. And this will just make them look like they're flying a bit. Oh, okay. So what I'm gonna do, so don't worry about if you get a little extra glue. The Mono Tombo will dry clear. So I'll just fold this guy as well. And I'll put him here. Okay. And then we've got these tiny little guys here. I don't know if I'm going to fold them up, but I won't glue them down entirely. if that makes any sense. Put a little dot of glue there. Actually, it might be easier for me to just put down some glue. Okay. You may decide not to use them all, and that's fine. I'm going to take this little blue guy here. Okay. So I didn't end up using him. I don't think the card needs it. So this is a very, very simple card. Super cute. I'll show pictures towards the end of the video. But it's very simple. You've got your craft cardstock, a bit of embossing or heat embossing, you know, a stamped card, and some faux stitching. And that's all there is to it. And what friend wouldn't be honored to receive, you know, a thank you card like this? So I hope you guys enjoyed. And we will talk very, very soon. Bye!